was not only a painter, he was an etcher, sculptor, ceramicist, and he did costumes for the ballet and scenery for the theater. The other reason being, he started when he was 13. His father was an art teacher, and he recognized his talent. And then he worked up until his death in 1974 at the age of 91. Huge career. As far as his genius, well, he has sparked the imagination of artists from surrealists to abstract expressionists to pop artists. This painting is definitely the most well-known artist of passing. This is his double.
Thank you.
1953. Vincent was a very sensitive, emotional child. He wanted to be a pastor like his father. He did go to seminary, but he said he found more spirituality in painting than in nature. Poor Vincent, he only had a 10-year career. He started late, and tragically, he died at age 37 from a mysterious gunshot. But in that 10 years, he did 900 paintings. He only sold one in his lifetime. Do you know what one of his paintings sold for in 2017? $81 million. The man didn't have enough money to buy the paintings. Look at this. But we know about him because he wrote letters, like 1,000 letters back and forth to his best friend and brother, Theo. So here you can see the...
You see this? I cut off my ear to give it to my sweetheart. But I'm an upgrade, and you can quote me. It is better to live in high spirits, even though you might make many mistakes, than to be narrow-minded. One must work and dare in order to really live.
Let's female figure when his eyesight started to go and he got into sculpture. Now, when this sculpture was first unveiled, the public did not care for it. Can you believe it? Because she was wearing a real tulle tutu, satin bodice, ribbon in her wig, she had real hair, and she had ballet slippers made by a doll maker. We don't know much about her, but we certainly know that they've redone her costume many times over the years. It's sort of disintegrated, and they realized that it has much shorter than it should. Recently, the Metropolitan Museum made a longer tutu. This is Umla from the Met. So, and of course, they took away the wig. But she's just beautiful, isn't she? Let's look at this painting over here. Gorgeous. Isn't that beautiful? I don't know what Edgar would say, but
Italy approached me at the dance studio, where I loved to sketch her sister's ballet classes.
Look at this.
She wanted to work for me.
This.
Apparently, she needed to take more classes, because her dream was to become famous dancing at the Paris Opera Ballet. I don't know if she became famous dancing, but she did become famous as the model for my sculpture, the 14-year-old ballerina.
time she'd come home. And I felt caught in this endless moment, waiting for her, waiting for me.
Thank you.
belong to a group of artists that call themselves the New Paint. And that's because they were trying to do something new. They wanted to blur the lines, they wanted to get rendering, you know, sort of like Raphael's. They wanted to be more different, a little different. So, and they had their first art exhibit. A cynical critic called them Impressionists. The name stuck. They are the Impressionists. Now, this room that we're in is Monet's panels. There are three panels, 5 feet by 7 feet. And you just feel like you're in this garden. Surrounded by these color. Let's sit on the bench and hear them.
When I was able, I purchased a plot of land outside of Paris. I built on it a lily pad and a pond. And on this pond, I also built a Japanese footbridge. This lily pond became one of my most favorite places to paint. I love the ways the light danced on the water.
Thank you.
influenced by Picasso, Paul Cézanne, and the whole expressionist movement. By 1938, though, with the threat of Nazi occupation in Paris, he and his Danish-born wife, Holga, went back to New York City. She was also an artist. And by that time, a lot of the European artists had also fled to New York, which made it the center of the world. It was the art center of the world at that time. So, a lot of art came out of that period. It was, for him, this cafe, he used, you know, some folk art feeling to it. And a lot of the Harlem Renaissance. This was his Harlem Renaissance period. But you see it? Oh, Mr. Picasso.
See me now, huh?
Yeah.
Oh,
nice. Did you know William Johnson?
Oh, yes, William. Oh, great guy. Billy. We used to hang out in a lot of the cafes in Paris. You did that a lot back then. Wonderful, wonderful painter. Excellent drinker.